Hello, everybody. Welcome into Talking Fitchburg on this Wednesday, June 2nd, 2021. I am Jeremy Crosby. Hope you had a wonderful day, another nice day out there on this June 2nd. And we have a very busy show coming up for you here on Talking Fitchburg. Back in the studio today. This is the last time we've done two shows in the studio back-to-back. Can't even remember, Andrew. Andrew's sitting right next to me, by the way. You can't see this, but he's literally, like, right here-ish. That's probably better so he can control everything I'm doing over here. There you go. That was not my hands. We've got, like I said, a busy show. We'll get you updated on the headlines here in just a moment, including some soccer highlights from last night's Bobolite Memorial and Verona. We'll take you out to that one here in just a little bit. We're going to take you out to a ribbon cutting. Madison Reading Project had a ribbon cutting recently, and we didn't have a chance to bring that to you on the specific day, but we are going to take a look back at that one here on the show. Plus, take you out and to introduce you to a solar project being placed on a local church here in the city of Fitchburg. We'll have that story for you coming up as well. We're going all over the place today. I'm excited. Let's, what do you say, throw the jacket on, Andrew, and hit the road here? Actually, you probably don't want throwing the jacket with this first story. Heat Awareness Day, and it's heating up. I mean, this is pretty timely, if you ask me. Today is Heat Awareness Day in Wisconsin. National Weather Service Milwaukee Sullivan wants to remind you, which is appropriate time to give you a warm-up expected into the weekend. This is like perfect timing, as I said. It's a great time to check in on our elderly loved ones and neighbors who may not have taken their storm windows down from the winter or haven't put in their window air conditioning units yet. The other side of the age bracket that are vulnerable are babies and little ones that are left in a car. Even with the windows cracked, it can still get hot enough in your car in 10 minutes for a child to have heat-related issues. Their bodies are less able to adapt to heat than adults, and unfortunately, yeah, get yourself in trouble big time. So please consider these things when you going in the extreme heat. Drink plenty of water. Check on your neighbors and friends. Help remove storm windows. Install air conditioning units. Make sure they work. Check the back seat for babies every time you go out. 10 minutes is all it takes for a loved one to be passed away. Even in when you think it's not so hot out, yeah, it heats up in the car really fast. And most susceptible to heat-related illnesses, elderly, infants, and young children. Watch for the children to get really red in the face. Maybe they're sweating, maybe they're not sweating. All signs of an issue going on there. People with disabilities who are on certain medications, those who work outdoors or in a hot setting, individuals who lack air conditioning or do not use existing AC. And in urban areas, temperatures tend to be warmer. So if you're in inner, you know, part of the cities, tends to be a lot hotter. So whatever the case may be, take the steps, be ready, especially because it is heating up coming into the weekend. All right, Public Health and Madison, Dane County, have ended their mask orders effective June 2nd. Public Health and Madison, Dane County lifted their public health orders, including mask requirements and gathering and capacity limits. When the order expired on June 2nd, mask requirements will become recommendations, and individual businesses and organizations may choose to enforce their own policies. After June 2nd, Public Health and Madison, Dane County strongly recommends that school and youth settings continue to require masks indoors settings as outlined in the latest CDC guidelines. And we'll keep passing on health information, any changes that do come up right here on Talking Fitchburg. Sticking with the masks, masks still will be required on Metro buses. So if you are going to be taking a ride, I guess, if you want to say, with Dane County health order expiring on June 2nd, Metro will be removing its capacity limits on the buses. However, due to the continuing federal law, masks are still required on buses and transfer points and bus shelters. So keep that in mind. If you are using Madison Metro or Metro bus system, you do have to wear a mask when you're going on there. That is a federal law, not a state, not a local. It is a federal law. All right, ever wonder how we keep the vaccine safe when you travel off-site? This is coming in from Public Health of Madison, Dane County. I got a picture for you here. Ever wonder how they keep the vaccine safe? Well, take a look inside one of our coolers. There are a lot of different processes happening here. First, the ice packs keep the temperature of the cooler cooler within 1 degree. A cord connects to the thermometer that tracks the temperatures very closely. Baggies and baskets keep the different brands of vaccines separate. That green paper is the document prep the vaccine, the date, time, and drawn up. And a type of vaccine, maintaining safety of all vaccine is our top priority. Ready to get your dose? Visit Alliant Energy or a pop-up clinic. All you gotta do is go to publichealthmdc.com/vax, V-A-X, Andrew. All right, June 2021 is Alzheimer's and Brain Awareness Month. Governor Evers has proclaimed this as Alzheimer's and Brain Awareness Month. We honor the more than 120,000 Wisconsinites living with Alzheimer's or dementia and the more than 196,000 who are serving as caregivers. Yes, definitely something to talk about. We'll hopefully have a chance to dive into this a little bit more later in the month, but do some reading into this because those numbers are going to continue to rise for Alzheimer's and dementia cases in the near future. All right, National Safety Month is the perfect time to brush up on your food storage skills. If you haven't done so, we've got some safety tips here for you. National Safety Month is a perfect time to brush up on your food storage skills, whether you're putting food in the refrigerator or freezer or a cardboard cupboard. These food storage tips can help you steer clear of foodborne illnesses, some of those include but not limited to here is checking the temperature. So a refrigerator or freezer perishable right away. Foods that require refrigerator should be put into refrigerator as soon as you get home. Stick to the two-hour rule for leaving items needing refrigeration out at a room temperature. Never allow meat, poultry, seafood, eggs, or produce, or other foods that require refrigeration to sit in a room temperature for more than 2 hours. Or 1 hour if the air temperature is above 90. This applies to items such as leftovers, doggy bags, and takeout foods. Also, when putting foods away, don't crowd the refrigerator or freezer so tightly that air cannot circulate. Because guess what? That creates issues for you. Keep your appliances at proper temperature. Do you know you should have two thermometers? Two in your freezer? That way you can make sure one's working properly, the other one's working properly. They work together, Andrew. I just heard this recently. I didn't know. You know, if you should do that, though. You should check it. Do you know the temperature to keep your refrigerator at? Well, it's 40 degrees or below. The freezer temperature should be at zero, Andrew, zero. Check temperatures periodically. Appliance thermometers are the best way to know the temperatures that you are generally inexpensive as well to do so. Check storage directions on labels. Many items other than meats, vegetables, and dairy products need to be kept cold. If you are negligent to properly refrigerate something, it's unusual or usually the best to just throw it out. Let's get rid of it. And also make sure you use ready-to-eat foods as soon as possible. Yeah, that's why you make them, so you eat them. And that's why I am a little overweight. All right, let's go to some soccer highlights. We'll skip the last one and go to the highlights here for soccer. Last night, Verona Area Wildcats girls soccer team hosting Beloit Memorial. And guess what? It was Parents Night. Hello, parents. Congratulations to all of those seniors in Parents Night. This game gets heated up really fast here. A breakaway shot goal! That's right, an unassisted first goal of the night coming in just at around 4 minutes and 42 seconds. A little bit later here at the 7-minute mark, another clean breakaway here and a shot right in there. That's a goal! That makes it... look just a little bit too easy here again. Another same kind of direction there. That's a goal. One more goal here for the night. Beloit tries to clear out by kicking it out of the zone. And this happens so fast. A header. And wait, no. Yes, goal. There is your final score, Wildcats 13, Cripple Knights, nothing. Not a bad one there. I mean, header to header, that's pretty darn cool, if I have to say so myself. And it's been fun to be out there catching those games. You can watch all of those games that we've covered here, right here on the Comm Channel. All right, we're going to take a quick break. Coming up next, we're opening up our digest. And we're going to be taking you out to the Madison Reading Project. Just had a ribbon cutting right here in the city of Fitchburg. And we'll take you out to our new location next right here on Talking Fitchburg.
We're all just trying to keep things running for those who rely on us. That's why we don't have time to be sick with the flu. And especially this year, no one has time to get sick. Get a flu shot for yourself and those around you too.
I may never have met you. We don't go way back. Maybe we wouldn't even be friends if we did. But when you wear a mask, you have my respect. Because your mask doesn't protect you, it protects me. I wear my mask to protect you. Mask up, America.
Gaining weight was easy. All I had to do was sit down and eat. Losing weight's a lot harder. I have to work at it every day. But with every step, I lower my risk for type 2 diabetes and heart disease. And that makes every step, every choice, every day very much worth the effort.
Learn how you can help stop diabetes by losing weight, eating healthy, and staying active. Visit checkupamerica.org or call 1-800-DIABETES.
If you need to do something to feel okay to drive, you're not okay to drive. Don't drive buzzed.
Welcome back into Talking Fitchburg. We're in the Digest, and today we're going to be talking about the Madison Reading Project, a great organization that has now a location here in the city of Fitchburg, and they had a recent ribbon cutting. It's a lot of R's to say. And we were out there, and we want to make sure to bring you this story. Take a look.
We are just absolutely thrilled to be able to share this with you and with our community for many years to come. If you ever did visit our old office, it would fit just in the little back room of what is now our huge book center. And it is amazing to see the staff working inside, to see just so many opportunities of things that will happen in the future, and many things that we don't probably even know about yet, but are just little kernels. Are little words on a page that are going to inspire us to do even more and to do even more for the kids.
Madison Reading Project provides free quality books to children, families, educators, and many different community partners in the greater Dane County area. And we always want to help children and their families, encourage children to read, to love to read, and to grow their home libraries and classroom libraries. So we have many thousands of beautiful books that have been selected by our staff and donated by our volunteers and donors so that we can get them back out to children in our community. So our old space was on the far west side of Madison, and it was a great home, but it was starting to get extremely tight and definitely was in our plans to make a bigger space that was also accessible to many different people, that was close to a lot of our partners. And then we just needed more room for books, for our staff, for volunteers, and just a little bit of breathing room for what's to come next for Madison Reading Project. So during COVID, it was extremely difficult, but we had our busiest year during COVID, and that was really the push, was to try and get into our new space before this summer.
Reading and the doors it opens up for people is personal for me. When I was in the second grade, my teacher noticed that I was having difficulty keeping up. Through a combination of one-on-one support at school and my mother working with me tirelessly on my reading, I was able to get up to grade level and later excel. This built my confidence and established my lifelong love for learning, reading, numbers, and problem solving. The kids and their families that the Madison Reading Project serves deserve the same opportunity. This is why I am so passionate about their mission, what they've accomplished, and their goals for the future. On behalf of the city of Fitchburg and the kids and their families you support, thank you for your work to promote literacy and set kids up for success.
There's thousands of books here. There's books that are constantly going in and out, but we do categorize them in many different ways so it's easy for our staff or eventually for when partners and teachers come back into the center so they can find things pretty quickly. So whether they're organized by genre, if it's baby board books, is it middle school books, high school books, picture books, certain topics, and also we have a whole collection of Spanish language books as well. The books are truly, our main inspiration is to inspire children to love reading and to own the books. But we have hundreds of different partners throughout the area, whether it's an event that we might do with a partner once a year, and we also have many partners where we're meeting with them at least on a monthly basis to make sure that the kids they're working with have quality books throughout the year.
When I was a kid, I spent every summer visiting my dad in Princeton, New Jersey. We had a regular routine. We would pack a lunch, load up the car, and drive to the library. I would make a beeline for the kids section, looking for really any book I hadn't read yet. And we'd check out a stack of books for the whole family, and we'd head to the pool where I would happily spend the rest of the day in between jumping in the pool, coming back, and reading my books. And you can bet that if there had been a reading project, I would have been there. I would have been knocking on this door asking for books because I was and am a complete and total bookworm. So I am really delighted to support the work of the Madison Reading Project, and I can think of no better way to celebrate all of the books that they've given away over 8 years to Madison youth than by opening this book center. This is a great day for bookworms everywhere.
Well, books are extremely important. It's definitely a key part of literacy. And we found through the years that letting children as much as possible select their own quality books, whether those are brand new books or books they see themselves represented in, they might be books that they see different characters, whether they've seen them on TV, something that's definitely relevant to them that gets them excited, different genres, whether it's a picture book, a graphic novel, all of those different things add up and give a boost to children so that they're able to own that book and get excited about it and hopefully will reread it many times or share it with a friend or a family member. So we definitely, reading is definitely a huge component of learning and definitely want to try and help our youngest readers all the way up, encourage them to read so that they can have a great quality life thereafter.
Just over the weekend, we gave out our 200,000th book, which is just, it's amazing. It really is. So it did start with an idea, and it's one of the things that I think has always encouraged me to keep going and to keep pushing, is every book does matter, whether it's 100,000th or 200,000th, each individual book that we are able to provide to kids that will inspire them, that they will want to reread or share with a friend or with a sibling. That's really what I think our staff is so passionate about, and finding the most amazing books for all different readers, all different levels or languages, to really help spark that curiosity and love of reading.
There you have it. I'll get this posted up online so you can check that out. And of course, you can check the website of the Madison Reading Project. Does a lot of great work here in Dane County. We'll take a quick break. More to come. You're watching Talking Fitchburg.
Find good stuff at Goodwill and bring good home.
You could be spreading the coronavirus without realizing you have it. So follow guidance from authorities where you live and do your part. It's important to limit in-person interaction with anyone outside of your immediate household. But phone and video chat are safe ways to connect. It's also important to limit any social gathering. This advice applies to people of any age, including teens and younger adults. Visit coronavirus.gov for the latest information.
After you joined our family, it was like, I really do feel complete now.
Our hearts are made stronger by how we treat others.
Put her there.
The light you share can impact those around you, but so can the darkness.
Later, twerps!
Did Pete saying mean things bother
you? So when you reach out to another person, take a moment to consider how they will feel and let your heart be the key to making a difference. Because of you, someone's entire day, year, or even life can change.
In every heart, there's hope.
We're all just trying to keep things running for those who rely on us.
Ready!
That's why we don't have time to be sick with the flu. And especially this year, no one has time to get sick. Get a flu shot for yourself and those around you too.
It takes all of us to slow the spread of the coronavirus. So follow guidance from authorities where you live and stay home unless absolutely necessary. Use a delivery service for essential items like food and medicine. If you must make essential trips, stay 6 feet apart from other people. Wear a cloth face covering and wash your hands for at least 20 seconds as often as possible. Visit coronavirus.gov for the latest information.
Welcome back into Talking Fitchburg. Guest segment today, we are going to talk about solar. Yeah, we got solar right here, just above us here, actually, here at the city of Fitchburg, and a local church taking advantage of a solar project. And we now want to connect you with this awesome project. Take a look.
We have recently installed solar panels, 57 of them, I believe, is the number, which will provide about 85% of our power. It started several years ago, 2015, 2016, conversations took place about putting in solar at All Saints, and then it was, that conversation was dropped because the pastor retired. And last year, as we were talking about stewardship, both of our finances here at All Saints and stewardship of God's beautiful creation, the conversation came back up again. And because that work had been done several years ago, we were able to pull things together rather quickly to get an incredible project like this done during the pandemic, which is pretty amazing.
We're experiencing the effects of climate change all across the country and around the world. And we felt that this was something that we could do to help reduce the effects of climate change. We all have to do our part.
We did have a member who stepped forward to offer a challenge grant, saying that they would provide a $5,000 gift to the church. They would match every dollar given to the church up to $5,000 for this project. Now, we did work with Legacy Solar to match us up with a solar sponsor who put most of the money up front, and we will pay for the benefits of clean energy over the next 6 years in order to pay that back.
The building has a roof that's on a 45-degree slope, which is the ideal slope for solar panels. We've got a large southern exposure, which is also ideal. It just made a lot of sense to do it. Working on a very steep roof is always a challenge, but when I was talking to Midwest Solar, they know what they're doing, and they had scaffold jacks, and were very careful. The analysis indicated that this was the ideal location. We've got two peaks coming out on either side of it, which kind of shades the lower half of the roof in the early morning and late afternoon. They did a good analysis that the area that's covered is the best, most effective area for the panels. The expected lifespan for the solar panels is expected to be between 30 and 50 years.
It is estimated that our energy costs will drop from about $6,500 to about $600. So close to $6,000 in savings every year from the solar panels. And so we won't see those huge savings immediately, but after 6 years, we should see the full amount of those savings each year.
There's a saying that we should think globally, but act locally. And this kind of is one of those efforts where we can do that and save us a lot of money doing it.
I think the message is that everything that we have, whether it's our gifts and talents or our finances or the creation all around us, are all gifts from God. And we're called to be good stewards of those things. And so we are being better stewards at All Saints of our finances by having solar, but we are also being better stewards of the creation that God has given us, caring for this world so that we leave it hopefully not in worse shape, but working to care for the environment around us.
All right, there you have it. A neat project at that. And if there's any more solar, if you got a business or a local church that's doing solar, let us know. We want to share your story here on Talking Fitchburg. Take a quick break. Wrap up the show next. You're watching TF.
See on page 4 that the projections need to be flood. Next Thursday?
Seriously? Thursday? Can't do that.
Uh-uh.
This is really inconvenient.
I have yoga that day.
I have no time for this.
So
I can't do Thursday, but I can do Friday.
Disasters? Don't plan ahead. You can. Talk to your loved ones about how you're going to be ready in an emergency. Don't wait. Communicate.
I expect it to be a lot easier.
I thought it was going to be a piece of cake. I didn't know what step to take next.
I was transitioning from the military.
I was a vehicle gunner.
An avionics specialist.
I was an MP. Military police.
My friends thought I could do anything.
I missed my unit, my family.
Playing with my daughter, I felt like a stranger.
I was overwhelmed.
I couldn't sleep.
I just wanted to be by myself.
I didn't have a clear sense of what to do next.
I was too proud. And then I thought, if I'm going through this, other veterans have gone through it too.
Too, right?
I started to open up.
And it made a huge difference.
So I reached out. And I saw that I wasn't alone.
Because before I was able to take on my next mission, I had to take on just taking care of myself.
To find
purpose.
We are not alone. Other veterans have transitioned from the military and overcome mental health challenges. Visit maketheconnection.net.
Talking Fitchburg, wrapping up the show for the day. I want to thank all of our guests, which really we went out and filmed a lot of those guests, but congratulations to the Madison Reading Project and to local church here with the Great Solar Project. We're going to wrap up the show here by sharing this with you. If you haven't connected with us on Facebook, on YouTube, you're missing out. Apple TV and Roku. And I made the announcement last week, kind of a soft announcement. We're on Amazon Fire TV, folks. Check it out. We'll be right back.